Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red, that hardcore questing mod pack from Gideon Seymour. Now, what I'd like to do today is go through a spirit portal back as a dream from a dream world. I'm still in the dream world. This is a witchery thing, so what we have to do is we have to do several things. So let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make some golden apples. I'm going to make two, because I've got to go and kill the the nightmare, or the physical embodiment of the nightmare. Here I've got some snowballs because I need those for the portal. So what we'll do is we'll put these up here like this. Put them in there. Actually, let's put them like that. We need eight snow. So what I'm going to do now, you'll see I'm jumping up and down, and that's because I've got these free runners on. And they're pretty good. They give you, gives you full damage, and it also allows you to go up without having to press space all the time, which is a nice thing anyway. In fact, let's just take some of these. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go back into the mine one way or another. In fact, I'll press F7 because what I want to do is make sure there's very few mobs around when I'm actually fighting the nightmare, because it's quite hard. Right, that's that one, and there's also another one entrance to this mine somewhere else. Where is it? Should be up here actually. Yes, there we are. Well, it can't be down here, 'cause that's blocked. And here's a space I would like to put a torch down, just to be safe. This is strange. Maybe it's just over here. Oh, my system of wool is failing me at the moment. Well, that's just a dead end. And this is two, I think. I can hear a skeleton somewhere about. Oh, here we are. This is the other entrance. I don't understand that. That was just here was the first one. Oh, there it is. Look. Don't ask me how I didn't see that. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll just chop down these, and then we have a better chance of seeing the yellow brick. We don't need them in here anyway. So what I'm going to do is to make a quick little hole in the wall here. Not very deep, just about, say, three deep, because the nightmare is about, I think he's about three high. So he can't come in here, so I can probably bash him from the outside. That's the idea anyway. So what I'm going to do, first of all, is I'm going to put all the stuff that I don't need in this chest. I'll tell you what I haven't got. I haven't gone and got my bound blade. Let's go and get that. Because I do need the bound blade. Because all the other weapons will break before you actually get a chance of killing him. You see, that's quite effective, isn't it? So I should have the bound blade in one of these chests. Probably. Not that one. This one. This has arthropods 4, which is great for spiders, but not very good for the nightmare. Would have been happier with a better nightmare. I'll take the bow with power 3 in it as well. And some arrows to go with that. A sigil of elementary affinity, we'll keep that. And the magnetism 1 as well. And here I also got a hang glider. And that's quite good with the jetpack. It really does help actually get around a bit. Okay, so let's go down and start this thing. So the first thing we've got to do is to kill a nightmare to get this malicious hunger. I was just putting stuff in this chest, wasn't it? So things I don't need. I won't need the apples with me, and I won't need the hang glider, and I won't need the sigil of the green grove. But food's good to have, and weapons are good to have. And we'll probably use these when we come back and just drop them off at the base. And that skeleton's bothering me a little bit, because they are a pain. And I'll also take the armor off. I don't need the armor, because the first thing he does is he knocks your armor off, so there's no point in having it on. Right, let's put these down. I have those at the end here. And let's go back to the overworld. And here we are, back again. It's been a long time since I've been here. And here are a load of zombie pigmen. And don't ask me what they're doing here, I really don't know. Maybe we just get rid of them, because they might even be causing lag. One. Yes, it's on. Well, but the worst thing we'll do is... we managed to jump out, that's clever, right? There's anyone's going to be able to do that, I reckon. Try again. Another one got out. Well, for a short time anyway. One left. Right. Oh, somebody's dropped a... what have I got on me? That's so much stuff. Anything I can put away in here? Let's put away those. That was the... some more boots in there too. But they're a bit weak. In fact, we'll just shove everything, all these weapons into here, all these tools into here. Armour, I mean. We don't need those with us. See, the other sigil of magnetism is pulling those very quickly towards me. I must have something on. I've got a lot of... I don't think it's just fire breathing. A bit irritating if it is. Where's it coming from anyway? I don't even have the sigil with me. I wonder if that's a sort of a bug from the other place. Anyway, it doesn't matter very much. Let's get rid of these boots. Have a quick sort and see what we've got. We picked up 6 weak blood shards from those 6 weak blood shards. There's one of my coven witches. In fact, I do need to eat here. Okay, now let's go and put away the junk, the other bit of junk that we've got, which was just some blood. Rotting flesh, but we do need something else from in here. We need some so look, anything else that wants to go back in there? Gunpowder, let's see. We need to make a wormy apple, and for that we need some rotting flesh and some gunpowder. I think I shall take 4. I'm not completely sure. We shall soon find out. Apples we need as well. We'll do four wormy apples. Probably 2 is just enough. I don't know why I was thinking of 4. Actually, I was thinking you need double, but you don't. So what we have to do now is to make the apple of sleeping. To make an apple of sleeping, let's have a look for the apple, a wormy apple. Sugar's what I need, I think. So it's 1 sugar, 1 apple, and 1 rotting flesh as shapeless crafting. So we'll just put 2 of those up there, put the 4 in there, and we need some sugar. Well, just a bit of sugar cane will do. We should have plenty of that in this chest here. Chest is full as usual. And there's my coven witch just come to say hello. Which one have we got today? Juliet Vampire. She quite often gives me a bit of a shock when she comes and says hello like that. Right, sugar. So now we have two wormy apples, we only need one. And the usage of this, let's have a look at the usage, is this recipe. It says it's an apple, but it's not. It's an apple of sleeping. So we've got a brew of sleeping, and 2 weeks of misfortune, and three. So, mutandas. So let's get those out of here. I think this is a quick sort, because sometimes I can't find things. One, two, three of those. 2 weeks of misfortune. What was the third thing? I've completely forgotten. 3 seconds, I've forgotten. Dreadful. Let's have a look at the recipe for this. So we've got it on us anyway. So it's the brew of sleeping, three mutandis, and two reeds of misfortune, and a wormy apple. Well, now it gives me an apple, which in fact is an apple of sleeping. And this is guaranteed to bring us back into a nightmare world. So before I go, let's just get rid of some of this stuff that I don't really want. In fact, we could even eat the apple, the golden apple. Let's eat this notch apple because we've got plenty. Okay, now let's go into the nightmare world. And I should have, I'm hoping, we will have the effect of the other one. Now we've got our areas. So we have to keep hitting this guy. He's got 100 health points, it's quite a lot. I don't know where my little hidey hole's gone to. Alright, he's on his way now. If I get to him. And he will drop, which he's just done. I hope now we've got this one, the Maleficent Hunger. So let's go back. Now we're on that step, so we want to go and find the other steps. I think we're still in a nightmare, so we have to be careful, because another one will spawn. Do I have anything to eat? Yes, I do. Let's make sure we eat these malabaries. The reason we're going to eat these is it gives you full 100% saturation, whereas another one, as I said. Now we have two choices here. We can either kill this one, which is what I intend to do, 74 health. But at least I've not got any other mobs around at the moment. 48. Come on, go. Right, he's on his way. If I can get him. Gosh, he's hitting me a lot. Now my health's low. Be able to just do it before it kills me. Of course, got him. Right, that's it. So let's now come out of there. We're going to make number three. Let's eat these quickly and come back to the real world. So now we should be able to get ourselves fully fed again, which we don't need to. What we have now is these two Maleficent Hungers, and what we need that for is a circle magic item, and I need to pick up the other one, so let's do that first of all. Circle magic. I need to make another talisman, just the blank one. So that's one diamond. I'll put those there so I know where they are. Four nuggets and four ingots of gold. Don't see anything there. We'll take that one. And we've got a blank talisman here. So I need to get some more gold. Put that in the middle. Plenty of gold in here. And here she is. Oh, that's Mercedes Derive. We've got her as well. fact, what happened? I don't know whether I said this or not, but I was giving her the necrotic stone, and I don't know what happened. The second time I did it, simply right-clicked with her. It worked. She became part of my witch's coven. So this one here. Now we want two redstones. And we also need one gold chalk and one otherware chalk. So let's move some of this stuff out of the way and start to paint in the, what we need. I haven't shown you the... should show you that first, actually. Oh, look. Here's my spectral familiar sitting down. Let's see if it gets out of the way. Come on, spectral familiar. You can move now. Can I move him? Yes, I can. Right, you can sit him down again. So what we can then do, so we can come along here and just make sure I've got my signal of magnetism turned off, which I haven't. Oops. Try again. Did that actually do? Didn't hit the spectral, did it? No. So let's put into here now one talisman and one redstone. In fact, he's still in the way a bit, actually. Let's get rid of it. Right click this. Oops. Probably too near. Try again. So that's now taken that circle. So that's just a small circle, ritual circle. And we have to do the same thing again. This time we have to use this otherware chalk. Where's the gold chalk gone to? Did I not pick it up? Oh, never mind, I'll get it in a second. So we need three of these, like that. So just 1, 2, 3, one in the middle, and over here too, 1, 2, 3, one in the middle, and I have to move this pig out of the way, all my spectral familiar, so I can put this one down here, and that's a circle done. Now I need just to get the other chalk. I thought I did pick it up, never mind, it should be, I didn't, put that one back. Actually, I can sort this chalk. Just that, I don't want that poppet. I probably want to get rid of this one. I'm going to put this in this chest. I really want to get rid of this rotting flesh, but it doesn't matter very much. Oh, sorry, wrong one. So now, what we need to do is the brew. The ritual, sorry. Let's get the book out. In fact, I'm feeling my chests are a weeny bit full. I'll tell you what I'll do. Let's quickly go and upgrade one of these chests. So we need one wood. I'll surround that by iron, which I should have plenty of. And then we can upgrade that chest. Can't upgrade the obsidian chest, of course, because that's really max. Now I've got space, so let's put some of this stuff in here that I don't really need with me. In fact, we'll put it all in as much as we can anyway. So this is the one we get rid of the quest book. This is the one we want. We also want this brew sleeping to go back again. And the chalk we don't want either. Let's sort that. It's funny how it does that. Poppets, it seems to have a problem with sorting poppets. Right, we'll put the poppets in now. Oh, and the death protection poppet. I should do that as well. So we need a tag lock kit, and that's just a bone needle. And the recipe for that is one flint and one bone. Fairly straightforward, gives you 8 bone needles. And then the recipe for the tag lock kit is just one bottle with a bone needle. What we do with this now is we actually go and bind this death poppet or death protection poppet to myself. So I come to my bed and right click it, and you'll see it's now filled up with bound to buddy woody. So we now just put those two together. I think it's on shape crafting, it doesn't make a difference. And now I've got a bound poppet here. This is bound to me. So I don't die one time. So we'll just put this. In fact, I'm supposed to have that on me. So I'll have it on me. Right, now. The rite. Let's go to this rite. That's the rite of necromancy. And we need the early one. So that's page 2. I think it's about page 7. We need the rich. The rite of transposition. Manifestation, this one here. This is where we needed the spectral dust and the mill of his hunger from. We've got a necromantic stone, a gold pickaxe, a thana, and gunpowder. That's quite a set of stuff, isn't it? Let's just I'll keep that. Let's move everything out of the way except for what we actually want. So we want the book. So it was one mill of his hunger, so let's put the other one away. Don't want that. One gold pickaxe, one Athana. Let's make a gold pickaxe. There's two gold in there. We'll get some more. No sticks in there, but plenty of gold. Let's do that. And let's go over here. We should have some sticks, or at least we've got plenty of wood. Two birch planks will do. Put those two sticks in there, and like one gold pickaxe. So we need a spectral dust, which we should find actually in here. Or maybe I've moved it out. I've moved it out. Should now be in here. So we need a necromantic stone, that's that one. And where is it now? Spectral dust, it's a green sort of powder. Here we got 8. So let's have a look at the book. What have we got? Spectral dust, yes. Maleficent hunger, yes. Necromantic stone, yes. Golden pickaxe, Othana, and gunpowder. Ah, that's what I was thinking about with the gunpowder. So we need one of those. 3, 4, 5, 6 items. Just check this now. So we need an altar power of 5,000 and this other wear chalk around here. And we need to stand in it in the circle. So let's get on with that. Right, I should be in the circle now. Yes, I am. So let's put these ingredients in here. And right click this. Did I right click it? Have I missed something out? Let's have a quick look at the book again, I think. One, two, three, four, five, 6. Oh, yes, I've got to do this at night, haven't I? So I have to wait till night time. How long have we got till night time? I do have a clock up here. Well, it's midday. It's just after midday, so we have about 5 minutes to wait. So what can I do in 5 minutes? Well, we could have a quick look at this. If you remember right, I built the same construction or similar construction in the dream world, and it wasn't working. So look at this jetpack here. And I don't see why. So it's basically, it's one block high. It's on one block and it's got a slab in the middle and its size is 3x3. And all I've done is put two slabs on top of that, didn't I? So one at the top and then one on top of that. And I've got plenty of bats in there. In fact, we could actually get the other Anthana out and actually see if we can get some more wool of bat. I think it's in here. Yes, this is the one I use for slaying mobs. We should just pick these, simply right click these. And as you do it, of course, you get Will of Bat. Ah, do you know what the problem is? I haven't got my signal of magnetism on. Let's just do that quickly. It's really a very useful tool, this one. I don't know why people don't like it. This is a little bit expensive. Look at these, they went all the way over there. So from those five bats or so, I've got five Will of Bats. So we can put these in this chest here. Don't need this at the moment. In fact, I'll put that back in this chest. So what were the six items that we needed? These six, and of course the order doesn't matter. And it must be coming towards night time now. Let's have a quick look. Yes, it is. Once we've got this right, the next bit is very straightforward, so we should be able to do this and quite quickly. So let's go and get this thing set up again. Oh, do you know what I haven't done? I haven't put down the gold chalk. That's not going to help at all. I don't know why I forgot to do that. Right, there we are. And I do want this talisman, and I do want the, once I've done it, I'll put the pattern in here, so that should be enough. Now, I reckon it's night time, so let's try this again. Of course, I've got to turn off the signal now of magnetism, because everything's got pulled to me. Right, so here we go. A bit too far, but let's just step it back. And so now in the circle. Oh, what did I just lose there? Nothing good. I was too near the middle when it picked it and picked up the stuff again. Let's try again. But I've got to be inside the circle, so that's the important bit. And I think that's it. We actually get the necromantic stone back again, that's actually good. And we usually get the Orthander back anyway, so let's put these two in here now. Oops, step back a bit. And pick up this. Trouble is you don't know. I have no way of knowing whether I've actually got this right, but I think I have, because I tested it out and the same thing happened. I didn't have any idea that I actually got it. Put this in this chest here if there's space. There is. So sort this chest out. So what don't we need in here? We'll probably leave the necromantic stone, and I should also leave the Orthanon in here. And the rest of it I'll keep with me. So now let's go back to the dream world. Hopefully in a dream. There is one more thing I can help to guarantee that I get a dream as opposed to a nightmare. And that is by putting a pool of the brew of the flowing spirit in front of these. So we could do that. I'm not sure how deep these go, to be honest with you. Let's have a look. Because I've left all my tools somewhere else. Yes, that's what I was a bit worried about. All right, we'll have to get some tools and do this properly. Where have I put everything? I want some stone bricks, don't I? That's weird. Stone bricks, 15, more than enough. weird as well, you lose your XP somewhere along the line. I should have probably backed up my XP, so to speak, built a little XP drain. Hello. Yes, Mercedes again. I haven't seen. So, what do I want? Pickaxe or something. Where did I put that? Did I put that over here? Just. Oh, yes, I did look. Is there anything else useful in there? I think the pickaxe will do what I need. Faffing around, I'm afraid, but there we are. Use the pickaxe on the wood. Oh, you come back again already? Wow. So drop down here and put above it some stone. Let's just do it like. Actually, that's all we really need to do. Fly up again. Oops. Not flying very straight today. Let's try again. There we go. Now, of course, I can then put the stone down here, no problem at all, fill in the holes. And I've gone and left the brew of the flowing spirit somewhere. Sleeping, I've got plenty of. That's brew of sleeping. And the brew of the flowing spirit. Ah, it's there, look. Nope, that's brew of love. Well, I'm going to put it down somewhere. Where did I put it down? Did I leave that in this dream world? Let's just try this. And double click. They've got those two brews, sleeping and brew of sleep. No, I must have left it behind. Oh no, here we are, brew of the flowing spirit. That is actually quite a useful searching technique, by the way, double clicking here. And it goes yellow, you know it's the selected one. Right, let's just put some of these splash potions down here. We can do three actually, maybe just two. And then we have a nice little pool. So now, in fact, yes, I do need those with me, or at least one of them. So we'll now try another sleep. And hopefully we come back into the normal world. I guess my health's a bit low from previous time. Let's eat some of these. I can't eat, what's going on? It's very strange. Ah, there we go. And this is the chest where I put my stuff from previously, so we'll get it out again. Don't need these. I want the hang glider, great sigil of Green Grove, and these two. We can leave the golden apple and the cobblestone in here. And there we go. Actually, well, that's before we do that, let's put these things on. Get myself protected again, and then just walk normally. Actually, now, I wait. There's a risk of mobs spawning because it's raining. It's the only time in the dream world there is a risk. So, what did we want? We wanted snowballs. Did I put those in? Ah, they're here, aren't they? We just need another 7, I think. Let's have a look. Wrong chest. I haven't got any more at the moment, but I should have the sickle of the Green Grove with me. So if I hit these 3 times, they should get picked up by the harvester. And if they don't, we can pick them up ourselves manually. Three. In fact, it is picking up some of these already. So let's have a look what we've got. Five. That's enough. And of course, we also get icy needles from the snowballs, which is good too. Put those in the chest and they'll get planted. That's it, eight. So now we need to do is make the portal. And I suppose it doesn't really matter where I make the portal. You see, I did the same in here. It just doesn't work in here, but I haven't got slabs on top of it, but that's only for basically to prevent the mob spawning. Where should we do this? I suppose it doesn't really matter very much. We can do it. We could do it here. So it's a very simple portal. It's a 2x2. It's a 2x2. Like this. And then we need a block on the top there. So what do we have for blocks? I'll use a block of dirt, I think. In fact, while I'm here, let's eat a bit more because there's still a bit of a risk. But what I also need is a bucket, and I didn't pick one up. Let's pick up these buckets. An empty hand is probably best. We only want one. Wrong way around. That way. Put the other nine up there. And the reason I need a bucket is I need to pick up the brew of the flowing spirit. You see, you get spirits and all those stuff up here as well. So let's put a piece of dirt on top of this, if I can. It's a bit strange, actually. Let's put the hover mode on. I think I changed the keystroke for this as well, because it was conflicting with the portal gun. I had a G before, now I've changed it to X. So we can do that. In fact, now all we need to do is make a little hole here. It's taking a long time. Okay, and now we've put into here the A Brew of the Flowing Spirit. I don't see it. Where's that gone to? That's strange. I used two and it's of I'm sure I haven't done anything strange with it. Oh. That's very strange. Is it down in the mine? Let's quickly have a look. I'm sure I didn't leave it there. I thought there was only cobblestones and something else I left down here. Golden apples. What on the earth has happened to that? Because that's supposed to come with you. Ah. I wonder if it doesn't come with you if you go the other direction. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. We shall quickly go back upstairs and make another brew of the flying spirit. But I have one thing I'm missing, and that's some wool of bat. So what I'll do is I'll pause the video. In fact, I might even have to save this till next time because I've run out of time. It's 40 minutes on and I haven't managed to do with it. So all I do is put some Brew of the Flowing Spirit down here and that's it. Oh, that's a bit of a shame. Must be some spiders in that thing. Quite noisy up there as well. Okay. So this time I'm going to do that. Next time, I'm not sure what we're going to do. We'll finish off this this task of doing this thing. And I'll come back. I'll see you later on. Oh, sure. Yes, bye for now. Right, I'm back. I just needed to make another brew of the flowing spirit. I wanted to do that because it seems a shame to leave the episode not completely complete. So let's simply put these items into here. And with a bit of luck, we'll have another brew of the flowing spirit, which is looking good because I can see it's bubbling green. And the only thing I didn't bring with me is some bottles. No problem. I'll just have a quick look in this chest. Yes, I've got plenty. And I've got, of course, I've got my witch's robes on. I see it's bubbling nicely. So let's just take this one. Oh, I've got more. Good. I got three. I think that's a good one, in fact. That's the advantage of putting on the robes. I think you normally only get one, but let's have a look at what it says in the recipes. I think I probably would need the other book for the brews one to find out. So what we can now do is finish this off. So all I need to do is to chickens. I made another water seagull, by the way. So let's just throw one of these in here. Oops, try again. Right-clicking it this time. And then taking the bucket up here, let's put the dirt back into that hole. And all we're now doing to do is to put the brew here, and it makes the portal. And if I've got everything right, I should simply be able to walk into this portal and come back to the real world. Or the real world, not quite the real world, as a ghost. So let's have a quick look if I'm a ghost. Yes, I am. Look, there we are. I can hardly see myself. And the only thing I've got with me is icy needles, nothing else at all. F5 again. Better. Just double check, just icy needles. So to go back again, I either wait for the time, and the time is about 3 minutes in my case, because I've got three other witches in here. But I don't know what to do now, if you see what I mean. What is the point of being able to come back as a ghost into the real world? And if I come round here, where I went to sleep, you should see me sleeping. There we are, look at that. Isn't that cool? But I'm not sure what the purpose is, so let's go back to the dream world again. And we come back here, and I can still hear that skeleton, and we should be coming back as a normal dream. So that's it. I managed to complete the quest, so it's obvious that you cannot bring Blue sleeping back with you once you've been through here. So let's put those into this chest here. Okay, until next time, bye for now.